if you're sticking around, it's because you wanted to see how to make an appendix, which is a way to cite images in a source, right? So again, we're looking at my old master's thesis as an example. So no, I do not expect you to write a 69-page paper. And by the way, my appendix doesn't count towards the page count anyway. In any case, what an appendix does is it allows me to reference visual sources without interrupting the body of my text, right? So you can't, unfortunately, sorry to be the bearer of bad news, but you can't put 4 pages worth of Chinese propaganda and submit it for Friday and get credit. That's not going to get you anywhere. But in any case, all joking aside, obviously these pieces of evidence are not Chinese propaganda. Mine was much more niche than that. Mine's actually a history of the Connecticut coastline. I could talk to you about it more, but we don't have time for that right now. So as you can see, right, what I do is I, after the end of my paper, but before my bibliography, right, I create an appendix. Now, you could actually call this appendix, but I called it appendices, which is the Latin plural for appendix, okay? Or actually the English plural too. Anywho, you could actually label each one individually. Now, this is a PDF, so I can't edit it. Again, this was the final thesis I submitted, right? The final draft, so I cannot edit this document. But in any case, you could, while you're working on it, you could call it Appendix A, right? And the reason why you might want to do that is so that you can actually cite it in text. In this particular paper, I actually did not cite these in text as much as I did to use them almost as an epilogue. So instead of showing you how I cited them in this, I want to just create a little sample. You know, I'm realizing I can't even save this image as an example, which is kind of a bummer. Let's see. I'm gonna just sort of pretend. Let's just pretend like there's an image. All right, it's kind of silly, but okay. So we got our citation here again. This is not necessarily completely in MLA. I wonder if I highlight it this way, if I can highlight the text or the image. I don't know. I don't think I can. In any case, I'm not gonna waste time. So I'm copying just this. Okay. Now, let's imagine our bibliography is down here, right, or works cited. Our paper ended here. So that would mean that actually, if you create an appendix, it should be sandwiched in between the two, right? And you start a new page also for the bibliography. So if you create an appendix, you might be turning in, you know, a relatively long document. Don't let that overwhelm you. Oops, I can spell. Alright, so I'm eventually going to hit enter a whole bunch of times so that the bibliography starts a new page. That is how you spell appendix, isn't it? Okay, I'm not crazy. I'm going to call it appendices, and then let's pretend again that we're going to put that Bridgeport map picture in there, right? So now you can say appendix. Oops. I really can't spell. Appendix A. And then this is where you would put the image. So pretend like the image is here. And of course, as you notice, let me just go back to the draft to show you. As you notice, you don't have to align it. I just have mine aligned to the left. Some of them almost look center because they're so big, because all the images come in different sizes. I tend to have one image per page just so that you can really zoom in on them. So again, an appendix can be pretty long depending on how many sources you cite. Where was I? Then you want to cite it, right? And that's below the image. Okay? So your appendix can be as long as it needs to be. Just make sure that when you finish your appendix, because as you add to it, it may change where the bibliography starts on the page. Just make sure that your bibliography still starts at the top of a page, right? That your bibliography starts at a new page. I think that's it, but by all means, as always, feel free to leave comments in the comment box, obviously. In the meantime, I'll provide a few other links, including links for how to do this in Chicago citation style, if that is what your teacher or professor prefers. So in any case, without further ado, thanks for watching.